darkest hours, I see you shining in the blackest nights on earth. I can see you glowing.
Hey guys, to start off this DIY, you're going to need some painter's markers as well as white and silver spray paint, of course a lip balm as well as a base. Now, first thing you're gonna do is having to spray paint the base white color. And I did this indoors just because I wanted to show you guys on video under lighting, but I recommend you doing this outside, of course. And the next thing you wanna do is go ahead and spray paint the top, but I really recommend you guys not to use a takeout box. As you can see, it started to destroy the bottom and it wasn't really good. So I went ahead and spray paint this on a cardboard instead, and of course, like I said before, try to do this outside. So once the product is finished, you want to wait about a day before you start working on the designs and then assembling everything together. For this part, it's pretty self-explanatory. All you're doing is taking your lip balm and putting it on top of your base just to make sure it's very secure and push it down tightly. So I decided to first work on the top because I thought it would be the most complicated one. And if you guys don't know what it looks like, you could just Google the picture. There's a lot of references because they did make a lot of Star Wars toys that you guys can look at if you don't know what the designs are. And this part was pretty easy only because I was using painter's markers instead of actually painting. I think that this actually was my first time using these markers and I had a pretty good experience. So yeah, this part makes it a lot easier if you do use these painter's markers, but if you don't have them, you can just use regular paint and paintbrush as well. Shining now, I can see it. Some sorrow, it won't burn out. We'll face our fears. When you're finished, it should look something like this, and I decided to let this dry because there's some other colors I need to add to it. So in that time frame, I decided to work on the bottom, and I'm using the same blue marker here and just doing the same thing, and I'm referencing the original pictures. But of course, you guys can simplify what you see. The original pictures was a lot more complicated, but you guys don't have to draw everything you see as long as it semi-represent what the actual figure looks like. And I also did some designs on the side as well. Some of the details you might not be able to finish until you put in the other colors. So what I did is just start off with the main colors, which is blue, and then afterwards I can work on later. So I went back to working on the top of this because there was some black I needed to add to this as well as red. So I just went ahead and did that. Shining in the blackest nights on earth, I can see you glowing. Rising love, shining now, I can see it. So I just realized that I haven't shown you guys the drying process, but I wanted to tell you guys the markers do dry really fast. I went ahead and put a fan in front of the product, and then I just waited about 5 or 10 minutes and it was dry after that. Also, I wanted to show you guys the silver marker that I got. I use this on top of the blue, as you can see right there, but it is optional. You can choose to use it or not to. And that's pretty much it. Want to mention, the other thing I did was paint the inside of the lip balm white, as you can see on the top. And you guys don't have to do this if you don't want to. I just felt like it matched the bottom better. Basically, if you put too much paint, the top will have trouble closing, so try to minimize the amount of paint that you do on the inside. But it does close if you end up loading it up with a lot of paint, because that's what I did here. And this is the final result. Well, thank you guys for watching till the end of this video. I'm gonna be making more Star Wars stuff coming probably this week. So stay tuned and subscribe to my channel. I will see you guys in my next one.
the bright.